Dear students, in last class we have studied the drawbacks of overcurrent protection scheme used in protection of transmission lines. And then we understood what is the necessity of impedance relay. In this video, you will be learning the derivation of trip law for a simple impedance relay using the generic torque equation of electromechanical relay. Consider the generic torque equation of electromechanical relay. The generic torque comprises of the torque due to current fed to the relay say K1 magnitude of relay current square plus K2 into magnitude of voltage fed to the relay squared plus K3 into VR into IR into cos of theta minus tau plus K4. Where T is the net torque on the actuating structure of the relay. K1 IR square is the torque due to current fed to the relay current coil K2 VR square is the torque due to voltage applied to the relay voltage or pressure coil. K3 into VR into IR magnitude into cos of theta minus tau is the torque due to the directional unit we have also studied how the directional relay works. Tau is the maximum torque angle for the directional unit. K4 is the torque due to spring. Which can be neglected compared to the operating torque. When the relay is on the verge of operation, this equation is called generic torque equation of electromechanical relay, because if I make K2 and K3 equal to 0, then the relay becomes over current relay. If I make K1, K3 equal to 0, then the relay becomes over voltage relay. And if I make K1, K2, 0, then the relay becomes directional relay. From this torque equation, we can also obtain impedance relay reactance relay more relay etc. Now we will see how we can make this electromechanical relay to operate as impedance relay. let K1 be positive K2 be negative and K3 be equal to 0. Reason for making K1 and K2 non-zero value here is the ratio of voltage to current is impedance. In impedance relay, for me, directional unit is not important. So by setting the value of K3 equal to 0, I can avoid the feature of directional relay. Therefore, the relay will trip. If K1 IR square is greater than K2 VR square. How we arrive at this point? We have taken T is equal to K1 into IR square minus K2 into VR square, and we made K3 equal to 0, so that term will not appear, and we neglect here K3 value. So for operating torque to be positive, K1 IR square must be more than K2 VR square. And that is what we have written here. Which can be written as K2 into VR whole square less than K1 into IR whole square. And this we can simplify further by taking IR square on this side. VR square upon IR square less than K1 upon K2. Taking square root VR upon IR is less than under root K1 upon K2. VR upon IR is the ratio of voltage fed to the relay to current fed to the relay. That means it is impedance as seen by the relay. So you can write here VR by IR is the impedance seen by the relay. So VR upon IR we will denote as Z seen, the impedance seen by the relay. So here we'll write where Z seen is the magnitude of the impedance seen by the relay. Further, let K1 by K2 equal to Z set. Be the impedance setting. Thus, we can write if Z seen is less than Z set, then trip, else restrain, this is the trip law for the simple impedance relay. We can therefore describe the simple impedance relay as an overcurrent relay with voltage restraint.